Hello and welcome back to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. We were discussing BFS algorithm, and in the previous tutorial we saw how to find the shortest path between two nodes using BFS algorithm. Today let's write the program. So to find the shortest path using BFS algorithm, we need to follow these steps. First is requirements. We need starting node and target node. Because we want to find shortest path between two nodes, we need starting node and target node, as well as we need visited dictionary. We need to mark the visited nodes, as well as we need to store its parent node. That's why we'll take visited dictionary. Key of the visited dictionary will be the visited nodes. Value will be the parent node of that visited node. Next, we need to check for valid nodes. While writing the program, we need to check whether given starting node and target node are present in the graph. So that is check for valid nodes. Next, we need to use BFS algorithm. That is, you need to create queue and you need to add starting node to queue, and you need to visit that. You need to remove that from the queue, and then you need to check whether target node is found. When we reach the target node, we need to return path. If the removed node is not the target node, then we need to add all the unvisited adjacent node of that removed node to queue. We need to mark that as visited nodes, and we need to add its parent node to the dictionary. We need to follow these steps. Okay, so let's write the program. Here we have our add node function, add edge function, and this is our graph. It is dictionary, and here we are calling add node function, add edge function. Here we'll print graph. And here to create queue, I'm using this from collections import dq. And next, to find the shortest path, we'll write a function. So def followed by function name is shortest path. You can give any valid names. And here you need to take parameters, right? First, we need graph because we want to find the shortest path between two nodes, and that nodes are present in the graph. So we need graph. Next, we need starting node. So let's take a variable called node. Then I'll take another variable called target for target node. Next is we need a visited dictionary, right? I'll create that visited dictionary inside the function body. So the next step is I need to check whether given two nodes, that is starting node and target node, are present in the graph. So for that, first I'll check. Okay, first let's use if condition, and we'll check node not in graph. If it is not present in graph, print this message. Next, let's use elif. If target is not in graph, target not in graph. Okay, let's print this message, and else. If both the nodes are present in the graph, then we'll go to the else block. Here in the else block, first let's create a dictionary, that is visited dictionary, to store the visited node as well as its parent node. Next step, we need to create a queue. We are using BFS algorithm to find the shortest path between two nodes. So let's create a queue. I'll use this method, dq method. For that, here we have this from collections import dq. Next step is we need to take the starting node first. I need to mark that node as visited, and I need to add that to queue. So first I'll take visited node is equal to none. Okay, what is this? Here, visited is a dictionary. So in dictionary, we have key and value pair. So here, key is nothing but the starting node, given node, and its value is none, because the parent node of the starting node is none. Starting node doesn't have any parent node, right? So that's why I'll take it as none. Dictionary will look like this initially. Next, we need to add the node to queue, queue.append node. Next step is, starting node is added to the queue now. Next step is we need to remove that node from the queue, and I need to check whether that node is a target node or not. If it is not, then I need to add unvisited adjacent node of that starting node to queue. Then we need to find its parent node and all. Then again, I need to remove node from the queue, and again, I need to follow these steps. I need to check that is the target node. If not, then add unvisited adjacent node to queue. Here, next, whatever we'll do, that is removing the node from the queue, check that node is whether target node or not. If not, then we need to find its adjacent node. We need to repeat this process again and again until cube becomes empty. Here we are using BFS algorithm. So we need to take this statement while cube. When cube becomes empty, it evaluated as false, then it won't execute its body. Then here, take a variable to store the removed element from the queue. Q.popLeft. Okay, remove the element from the queue and store that in the variable current. And next step is I need to check whether that node, removed node from the queue, is the target node. Like this. After removing the node from the queue, we need to check whether that is our target node or not, right? So we'll do that. So if current is equal to target, if it is our target node, then we need to find path. If we found target node, then return path, right? So we need to do that. If current is equal to target, we need to find the path. How to find the path? First thing is I need to create a list to store the path. It will have one node or more than one node. So to store that nodes, I need a list. Then we found the target node. And we need to add that to path. Why? Because the target node is also part of path, right? So what you need to do is path.append, add that to list. Because current and target represent the same node, add that to path. So if you want to find the shortest path between A and G, like we did in the previous tutorial, here you can see in the path, G is also the part of path, that is the target node. That's why we need to add that to path list. Next, we need to add its parent node to path. So how to get the parent node? So to get the parent node, I can use visited dictionary, visited of current. Parent nodes are nothing but values in the dictionaries. To get the value, you need to use keys. So here, visited of current is nothing but the parent node of current node. Parent node of current node is nothing but the parent node of the target node here. So I need to get that and store that in current. Why current? Because in the next step, I need to append that to path. Then again, I need to get its parent node, that is here. First, we'll add G to path. Next, we need to get its parent node and I need to add that to path. Next, we need to go to D and we need to get its parent node, that is A, and we need to add that to path. Next, we need to go to A and we need to get its parent node, that is none. After reaching none, we need to stop, because if value is none, that means that is the starting node. So when we reach starting node, we need to stop, right? So that's why here, first you need to append the current node, that is the target node, to path. Then you need to get its parent node and take it as current node. And again, you need to execute this until current becomes none. First, create a list called path, append the target node to path, then get its parent node, add that to path, then get its parent node, add that to path. We need to do this again and again until current becomes none. That is the parent node of starting node. Next, here, when we come out of while loop, we'll have our path. This while loop will stop executing when current value becomes none, that is when we reach the starting node. So we have a path now. What we need to do is we need to return that path. But here problem is path is in the reverse order. We need to reverse that. That's why here I'll use this. To reverse the list, I'll use this. Here you can see we'll get path like this, but we need to reverse it, right? To get the correct path. That's why here I'll use this. We are done with this condition. If current is the target node, so if we found the target node, we need to find the path like this. What if the current node, that is the removed node, is not the target node? What we need to do? Here, if current node is not the target node, we need to add all the unvisited adjacent node of that current node to queue, right? To get the unvisited adjacent node, you need to use graph of current. And we need to get all the unvisited adjacent node of removed node. We need to get one by one and we need to add that to queue. So we'll use loop here. So I will be the adjacent node of current node, that is removed node. What we need to do? First, I need to check whether that node is already visited or not. So for that, if I not in visited, I'll compare this adjacent node with the visited dictionary. If it is already present in the dictionary or not, if it is already visited, no need to do anything. If it is not visited, then first step is visited I is equal to current. So what is this? If it is not visited, mark that node as visited. So add that to dictionary like this. So I is the adjacent node, that is the visited node, and current is nothing but its parent node. When I remove B, will add adjacent node of B to Q, and what is its parent node? That is B, that is nothing but the current node. Here also, will add all the unvisited adjacent node of A to Q, that is BDF. What is its parent node? That is A, that is the removed node, right? So here also same, here you can see removed node is D, will add unvisited adjacent node of D to Q, and parent node is nothing but D, right? Parent node is nothing but current here. Next, we need to add that to Q, Q dot append I. Okay, so we are done. Here, what we'll do is, first, we'll check whether given nodes are the correct nodes, are present in the graph or not. We'll check that. Next, if it is present, then we'll create visited set, we'll create Q. Next, we'll add that starting node to Q and take its value, that is parent node, as none. Then we'll add the starting node to Q. Then we'll remove the node from the Q. We'll check whether that node is our target node. If it is true, then we'll find its path. If it is not, we'll find its adjacent node and we'll add that to Q, as well as in the visited dictionary, we'll store the visited nodes and its parent node. We'll continue doing this until Q becomes empty, or we'll find the correct path. So let's call this function. Let's call this shortest path function name, then graph, then starting node, then here target node, and this shortest path function returns a value. So you can take a variable to store that, result equal to like this, and you can print that like this. Let's save this and execute this. Okay, be careful about function name. Let me take shortest path like this. Okay, sorry, spelling mistakes. Okay, in this graph, there is no shortest path from A to G. So let's change the graph. So here we have our graph. Okay, let's find the shortest path between A and G. And here you can see the output, right? Then if I take a node which is not present in the graph, like X, and if you execute this, here you can see X is not in graph. Here you can see another example, shortest path. And you can use directed graphs also, like this. Here we have a directed graph. Then let's find shortest path between A and E. And here you can see this is the shortest path. This is how you can use BFS algorithm to find the shortest path between two nodes. That's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.